DJ Khaled. Please, Khaled, don't pair me or compare me. Unless the said party is a rare breed. The stories I hear, they tend to...
Went very tough fight in the semi-finals. Oh, Cold Zero is one. And important crowd stops Ali from getting taken down as well. Very important crowd speak indeed. More Deagle fire coming in from the B-bomb site. No flank at the moment, but Rain is on the way. Two T's. Oh, man, these Deeks cannot be stopped at the moment. Two kills for Taco. Spots the bomb carrier as well. And SK, they're going to have the high ground. Phelps, he's the last man, but he's on the high ground. They don't know that he is there. If a default plant comes in, then maybe there'll be more problems here for FaZe.
Phelps, position unknown. The surprise element, that's how he wins this round. Still unknown. Great position. He's trying to play smart at the moment. Nice pickoff. Can collect the AK as well. All of a sudden, a doable round here for Phelps. Now, the only problem is Rain knows where he is, but he does not know where Rain is. Although I think he's got an inkling now. He's seen him over wide shore. The play comes in. Knife to try to dodge the angle. But just as Rain was moving as well, such a tense battle between these two players now as Phelps tries to get a superior angle. Trying to get it. Oh, Rain taken down to critical health. 2 points of health remaining on Rain. That could not have been closer. Can make this 3v3 very advantageous. Spots the one. Execution comes in. Onto 1-2 and the third on the spray. They're going in for the hunt. Finds himself a headshot onto Fallen and the finishing shot onto Cold. If Nico doesn't make that frag, it takes so long for FaZe to almost do anything. And here it is. That is so sick. And that's the frag that allowed FaZe to take that B bomb site in the first place. They had the positioning, but you have to have a player that can just go for those insane kills. Although Rain has found his way to a very close position on the slope. This may be very unexpected. Easy frag for Rain. Could be the difference maker as he picks that one up. Kiyoshima as well, winning battles towards this jungle position. But FaZe holding it down, 5 HP. And he'll get 4 kills in this round. Looking towards his position as, of course, all the distraction towards middle has definitely caught his attention.
Fallen's got to be careful now because Nico was just around the corner, but Cold Zero picked him off from the ladder position. Who does this favor? The man advantage is still with the CT side, and that CT is still on a Rain doing the job again.
And then Cold in the clutch situation. Those are the two players you want, but it won't work. Nico's in position. A quick duo of kills from him, or double that is, as they go 16 to 11. Yanko predicted a FaZe victory, James. CT side of this, playing it really well, avoiding engagement, still containing the T's and keeping perfect information. And there's the first engagement. Cold spotted. Nice peek from Carrigan. Knows Taco emerges from the pit position. Attack through the wall from the AWP of Alu. And the kill will come from Nico. Still trays all over the place. A 3v2 off the plant, though, here for FaZe to try to hold on with.
Phelps standing his ground on the long position. Alu moving into the pit. He's got a crossfire with Nico. I think he might be going into apartment, and Fallen biding his time top mid at present, and he will move in when it's time, when Fur is in position. So it's going to be a three-pronged assault from the CTs, but can the communication be fast enough if trades are required? That bomb is ticking. Fur's the only person with a kit. He needs to make it out of the balcony. The first kill comes in for Fur, and he's traded. The kit is in no man's land, and that might cause the loss for SK if they could even get this kill. And he's still alive somehow, still going for the no-scopes. They found the kit, it fell off the balcony, and they might just have enough time to do it.
If we play a normal style of Inferno on the defense and play passively and see what FaZe have to bring against you. I'm very curious, because FaZe will also know that at least has to come into the B-bomb site. Fallen's on the angle, nice shot there, just as the smoke blooms. Now it's Fur on the side, but another frag through the smoke from Fallen. Absolutely ridiculous stuff now, as Fur has all the time in the world to pick off the bomb planter as desperation sets in for FaZe.
On the B-bomb site, he was holding a flashbang from this position. He was ready to drop it into pool. Oh, the gap, are you serious?
There was a gap, I don't believe it.
He was holding a, oh my god.
Ooh, Fur, this aggression from him, he absolutely loves it. If his opponents have pistols, he will destroy them no matter what he's carrying. And it looks like Carrigan is actually going to be able to, with the help of Rain, take away these kills from SK. Kiyoshima, like, in this tournament, doing so well also. I feel like with this star-studded lineup, you sometimes see his name go, like, for example, how fast that shot was. That was so...
Lovely play, the information game goes instantly for the first kill. There was a second player there, but he won't know that. Oh man, two kills for Fern. He will make his escape all the way up banana.
4 times, maybe even 4 times in this game so far, in this first half. I have no idea how he gets away with this.
What?
Another smoke kill from Phelps. Just bang on there with that spray. Now the smoke will be pushed. Phelps easily deals with that one. Spots Rain as well through the gap. Rain spots him as well though, but he's got 5 players to find. He's looking for the trade fragger.
Again, there's only so much space with which to wield these weapons. That's not a good start for the SK side. FaZe looking to get double figures themselves. Nico and Carrigan holding things down around Banana. Again, another two-man spray down for Carrigan. Grenades, flashbangs, Cold Zero spotted, but not quite taken down. Clock continues to tick. He's forced forward into the crosshairs of Kiyoshima, continues to deliver for his team. 3 versus 2, and now Fur may be the first engager. Taku not far behind either. Big grenade damage, but can the bomb be defused? Not holding it quite yet, and it's Fur. They don't seem to know where he is. He's going wide, he's taking the bomb defuser down, and he's won the round for his team. 13 for SK, what a play from Fur. Carrigan and Nico keeping an eye on Banana while the rest of the team focus. Look at these angles. FaZe, they've been playing their angles pretty good. Their crossfires have been quite strong, but will they be strong enough now? Kiyoshima's got a lot to do. Two kills for him. He's done his job. Trades come in, but now it's the SK players. Pistols only with the man advantage. There are weapons to be collected here. Will the CTs allow him to plant the bomb? Nico coming around, but he can't get a kill onto Boiler. That is huge, leaving Carrigan on his own. Still, Phelps is the only person who's picked up a weapon in this round, but a bomb is planted and the advantage is not with the CTs. Trying to draw out some players that might give him some cover as well. Such a hard task. He's got no cover really to defuse the bomb. Set up with a 5-7. But Nico's just going to hold his angle around the fountain. He can try to reposition if he's fortunate enough. And indeed, he will do exactly that. Two more guys taken down by Nico, and Carrigan said a bomb falling towards his feet. 4 versus 1, FaZe, can they steal this round away? Carrigan going for a cheeky peek while the bomb gets planted. Taco looking away, facing the wall, that's where he will lie, FaZe.
As Alu almost thought he was going to take an aggressive peek again, but we get a fast approach of second middle from SK Gaming right now, as they perhaps look to get one of those early pickoffs towards these apartments in middle positions. FaZe have been comfortable playing passively so far. It looks as though that continues here in this round. In the 30th round on Inferno. SK Gaming shuffling out of the boiler area. Looks like they spotted the hole, but will that hole be plugged by the AKs here? It looks like Kiyoshima go down. It's down to Rain to hold on to this position. He'll get one, but still more need to follow if he wants to hold on to this position. So far, it's looking good here for FaZe.
Fallen still at bottom mid, waiting for that rotation, but it looks like his team might need some help on the A bomb site. Cole is on his own now, he's stuck and he's in a crossfire, but he's found an angle. It's a 2 versus 1, it's down to Rain, maybe the talisman of FaZe Clan, and that rotation from Fallen is coming in. There's an angle for the bomb to be collected, but it's a double pick from the Brazilians, and it's enough. We are going to overtime. This is not over yet.
It's crazy to see that situation happening twice, where SK are playing so slow that they're in this position where it's a desperate rush. You can see Fallen desperately needed to have that run boost. He knew that Ali was on the angle and respected him, that if he just does a dry peek like that, he's going to up into the quad position. Good flick from Cold. Still more players to come though, but they are slowing their roll a bit. They need to coordinate this. We have a wrap coming in. Cold, another one. Really important shot there from him. Can SK do this? It's looking really good for them at the moment. A 3 versus 5 here for FaZe as they make their way into this bomb site, and every single SK player is here to meet the push, here to destroy the FaZe Clan, to try to lift this trophy. They need one more map, and this is how they can get there. Kiyoshima now against three players. We've seen him here so many times. Oh, the tap's not good. Cold, great defense, and the map will go to SK Gaming. They tie things up here in this grand finals for ECS Season 3 against FaZe, denying them that map too. SK with a strong start here, that 4-0 indeed. And it's a very scary prospect when they start to get the momentum on the CT side. It's where they always used to do all the damage. And we have FaZe gaining the ground quickly, smoking Taku off here. A better approach, missing the shot through the smoke. So it seems like a first for SK. Oh, we get the mad dash towards connector. Almost all the T's wrapping around the front of the bomb train. Really interesting movement here. The maneuverability from these T's with the Tech-9s is strong, but the SK players are fighting back. Oh, wow. That's an incredible shot there from Taku. Still more players left to deal with though, as the bomb should be able to be planted, and indeed it will be. But who is left to try to defend it?
Alu and Carrigan. Alu has picked up an M4, but he's been dropped, leaving Carrigan alone. How much damage can he do in this situation? He sees one player, but what is his play? It's planted default, so I don't know that he can really stop the bomb from being defused, but He's trying to find something, presumably the AWP, but Fallen just swiping right, denying him in
top of the green train. What can he find? Nico finds the end of Taco's AWP, leaving it all to the dedicated AWPer of FaZe. But oh, so we got Cold in with a very nice AK shot. Well, have to hold that for. We got the Tech Knights in quickly here. Taco with a close range AWP, confusing it for a shotgun perhaps. Almost as good as in that position as we have Carrigan now. Well, he's no more. He is no more, James.
Fur is 20-4-2.
Oh my god.
All the MVPs.
Disgusting stuff from Fur.
His desired angles. Gotta be careful. Nico has a look, gets punished for doing so immediately by Taco, but Rain has closed the distance. Phelps is here, but Rain with a 2K. Down to 3-on-3. Phelps, continuation spray in case somebody's close. Not sure if you heard any sound, but now we've got a T in connector.
It's going to work out, looking for the timing. Oh, Fallen's missed him. Oh dear, that's a big problem now for SK. FaZe, perhaps they can close their first round on the board. They can be welcome to the scoreboard, perhaps. It's looking good, it's just Phelps left now. Now he, oh, it gets caught in the back by Ali. There you go, FaZe on the scoreboard. They get closer and closer. Fallen looking for the right timing. Oh, there you go. Ali with a great peek. Another one coming in, takes down Phelps. Just Cold on the bomb train now. Looking to hold it down. Ali doesn't stop though. Quick three frags from him with that AWP. Wonderful stuff, allowing FaZe to have space to take that A bomb site. Now as Fur, it's really hard. So many rounds against one of the world's best teams, one of the most experienced teams at the very top level, looking to reclaim that top level, looking to once again be frequently seen lifting trophies at championships in CSGO all around the world.
FaZe continue to climb, one stone at a time. Now it's their turn to get some smoke kills, FaZe Clan. For the spray, where's Cold Zero? It's a one-on-one. He's got a jump. Does he realize where the bomb is just yet? I don't know if he does. Cold Zero around the corner. Creeping. Kishima's got no idea. And finally, SK win their first round of the second half. Okay, you've got to be careful though. Alu doesn't miss often. 40 seconds remain. More smokes. FaZe trying to delay the timing of their opponents.
Just enough time for Carrigan to take out the grenade there and switch back to the gun. That was so close, and it's the first frag going to FaZe, and time indeed is so stretched. 20 seconds to plant now as Cold makes another kill onto Carrigan. It's going to be really hard to get this bomb planted though. The CT's all over the bomb train. How do they stop FaZe from winning this round at this point? Fur going for a desperate play. We have frags all over the place. It's 7 seconds to go. We even get a T-kill coming in, and it's going to be the round for FaZe. They've made it all the way to tournament point. Can he finish it here, or will we see yet more overtimes in this grand final as Kyushima creeps his way up to the bomb train, looking for every eventuality, his mind racing a million miles a minute at this point as he searches for the next player. Spraydown comes in. Where's the trade fragger? Can't find him in time. It's Fur to make the kill, and SK in dramatic fashion find the 15-15. Works towards connector, and on the bomb train is where Nico's going to plant in the 1v2 clutch here to bring a FaZe ahead in the second half for the first overtime. Nico looking for both players, suspecting of the smoke, suspecting of almost every single position at this point. He just does not know, has to go with his gut. Going up into the heaven spot right now, looking for the first player. SKR taking this slowly right now, seeing whether or not they can just find Nico. Walking around, but he will be waiting up high. There's one, but it's Fur from down below to take.
Surely he's gonna stop this plant from coming in. No, he's gonna pass the angle. Phelps will do the job. Phelps will do the job again. It's SK to take it. Back and forth. So many match points. But ultimately, the Brazilians fend off the insane comeback from FaZe and take the final and the championship.
Honestly, sometimes you just worry, don't you? You get those two epic maps where you couldn't have it even any better. And then you get that third map that delivers. After such a start, we see SK Gaming proving that not only do they have the Counter-Strike, the mechanical skill, the individual skill, the team play, the experience, but they also have the composure and the mental fortitude to take it against a team that can lift trophies.
A war of attrition. Finally,